So glad we've managed it to the end of the year. It was a stressful year, wasn't it? Mr. Bittis, how stressful was it? Terribly stressful. So, is this actually working? Lovely. So, we are going to be doing 9 acts today for you from the past century of some amazing musicals, The Greatest Showman. Now, we're going to start off with our first act from a play about something that I sadly can never use. It is Hairspray. Round of applause, please, for Hairspray.
Oh, It's a funny thing about mothers and fathers. Even when their own child could be the most disgusting little person they could ever imagine, they would still think that he or she is wonderful. Some parents go farther. They become so blinded by adoration, they manage to convince themselves that their child is qualities of genius. Well, it's not very bad. It's the way of the world. It's only when our parents begin telling us about the brilliance of our own off-revolting offspring that we begin shouting, "Bring us the basin! We're going to be sick!" Occasionally, one can discourage the parents to take the opposite line, who show no interest in owning their children, and these, of course, are the far less delivery ones, Mr. and Mrs. Burnwood. There is some called microbiotics of material garden. Delivered material garden and nothing more than a scab. A scab is something you have to put up with until when the tide comes, you can pick it up and flick it away.
By the time she was three, Matilda had told us that we studied newspapers and magazines that lay around the house. At the age of four, she could read fast, and well, she naturally began handing off the books. The only book of this whole enlightened household was something called Easy Cooking belonging to her mother, and when she had read this from cover to cover and read all the newspapers by heart, she decided she wanted to try something more interesting.
It started out from parents who ordinary children as if they were scabs and bunions, but it now becomes a lot worse when the child in question is extraordinary. By this, I mean sensitive and brilliant. Matilda was both of these things, but above all, she was brilliant. Her mind was so nimble that it should have been obvious to the most hard-hearted of her parents.
Oh, K-pop, so no, I cannot.
Thank you. Was known as Rusty Weasel. She will tremble to the
keep out of trouble and you double your choices. I'm with you, but the situation is wrong. You got to be careful you talk. If you talk, you're gonna get shot. Virtopia, Mr. Lafayette, y'all look like Lancelot. Sometimes I get over with something, shoot off at the mouth. I never had a group of friends before. I promise that I'll make y'all proud. Let's get this guy in front of a crowd.
Jesus, between all the bleeding and fighting, I've been reading and writing. helping out. So thank you very much.